We shall do everything humanly possible to uphold the honor, the dignity of our people, that these almost inescapable regime of suffocation, of subjugation, of total enslavement of our people must and will come to end in our time. It is not something we are prepared to live with, and we cannot tolerate it.
Biafra is a nation. It was a Biafra.
Do you want Biafra?
Yes, I want Biafra.
Why?
Because we have suffered a lot in hands of Nigeria, and we want to have our own freedom.
Do you know what Biafra is?
No.
You don't know what Biafra is?
Mm.
But some people are agitating for Biafra. Are you in support of what they
are? I'm in support. If it will be peace, if there will be a peace, but if there will be a kind of misunderstanding, no. I don't want to work.
Why don't you want to?
Because we need peace. Our country needs peace.
There is nothing good about Nigeria because Nigeria has nothing to offer. People in Nigeria are criminals, if you permit me to use that word. Why we really want Biafra is this. We need change.
To my own understanding, it's freedom. Yeah. If they will do it in peace, I would like it. I don't want problem, war, of maybe killing people, wasting life. If that's no. So if the thing will cause problem, it's better they leave it.
Since 1914, the Igbo man have never got a position in our own land. Since 1914, amalgamation, they never allow Igbo man to be in any good position. What brother the passenger call us? We are not his brother. He call us rebel. Can check it in the world, it's a record.
I'm one of those that fought and resisted the zoo called Nigeria. I was 13 years when I joined. I was 13 years. And because what motivated me most, or most of us that were in school that day, that time, is because of the vandals killed, after killing our people in the northern Nigeria, they had the mind to put these cops and injured people inside the train and shifted them to us for us to see what's happening.
To us, we were pushed away from Nigeria, so we decided to defend ourselves.
You were pushed away?
We were pushed away when there was pogrom in the north. So a lot of people returned. We were pressed to the world. We had no any other alternative than to defend ourselves.
Did you fight during the war?
I fought during the war.
As
a signaler. I fought as a signaler under 37 battalion.
So how was it like? What was it?
It was a horrible situation.
When Biafra come, all these hawkers, all these kidnappers, and robbers and stuff, okay. And they give us good road and electricity.
My dear friend, I had them back in the Lamegun, the Maro Biazoma here. Come, I had them by my Biafra, Biafra, do Mardi, Magamka, Gabia, Botanda, Hazuroma, here, I had them. So they get Macalo a walk.
Yeah, what I'm telling them, they said you should come back before 1st October. I'm advising them, you can't stay there. It's only stick, you say we kill if you stand. You make a move. They should make a move. It's high time they know where they come from.
Yeah, really? really, we have our government should now intervene, know how to handle these brothers when they come in this place. When they come in, our brothers, we have governors, senators, what are they waiting for? Let us invest here. Most of them, they don't invest here. What they need is to not have been able to not and invest, especially that's Abuja side. All of the other investments, the governor now would like to have investment in Abuja. We don't have anything on my head here. Just imagine, you see about Golden Guinea here. No, they're not talking about this. See the market. This is market, national or international market. See how loose these politics. What are you waiting for? It's just shameful to me.
As for this very proud Igbo race that I happen to come from, by the grace of God, I will do everything humanly possible to serve it with every ounce of dedication in my body, that one day we and our people can sit around and say that this was a fight well fought, and that now that we are free, we can begin to work towards attaining all those potentials that the Most High God gave to us. We shall do everything humanly possible to uphold the honor, the dignity of our people, that these almost inescapable regime of suffocation, of subjugation, of total enslavement of our people must and will come to end in our time. It is not something we are prepared to live with, and we cannot tolerate it.
Biafra is a nation. It was Biafra.
Do you want Biafra?
Yes, I want Biafra.
Why?
Because we have suffered a lot in hands of Nigeria, and we want to have our own freedom.
Do you know what Biafra is?
No.
You don't know what Biafra is?
Mm.
But some people are agitating for Biafra. You support the body
and all. I'm in support if it will be peace, if there will be a peace, but if there will be a kind of misunderstanding. No. I don't want to work.
Why don't you want to?
Because we need peace. Our country needs peace.
There is nothing good about Nigeria. Because Nigeria has nothing to offer. People in Nigeria are criminals, if you permit me to use that word. Why we really want Biafra is this. We need change.
To my own understanding, is freedom. If they will do it in peace, I will like it. I don't want problem, war, of maybe killing people, wasting life, without no cause. So if the thing will cause problem, it's better they did it.
Since 1914, the Igbo man have never got a position in our own land. Since 1914, amalgamation. They never allow Igbo man to be in any good position. What brother, the passenger called us? We are not his brother. He called us rebel. Can check it in the world, it's a record.
I'm one of those that fought and resisted the zoo called Nigeria. I was 13 years when I joined. I was 13 years. And because what motivated me most, or most of us that were in school that day, that time, is because of the vandals killed, after killing our people in the northern Nigeria, they had the mind to put these cops and injured people inside the train and shifted them to us for us to see what's happening.
To us, we were pushed away from Nigeria, so we decided to defend ourselves. We were pushed away when there was pogrom in the north. So a lot of people returned. We were praised to the world. We had no any other alternative than to defend ourselves.
Did you fight during the war?
I fought during the war.
As
a signaler. I fought as a signaler under 37 battalion.
So how was it like? What was it?
It was a horrible situation.
When Biafra come, all these hawkers, all these kidnappers, and robbers and stuff, okay. And they give us good road and electricity.
My dear friend, he had them back in the lame gundi marobiazo ma here. Kamri, I had them by mamma, Biafra, Biafra, dio, Mardi, Magemka, Gabia, Botanda, Hazro, my here, he had them.
So they get Macalo a walk.
Yeah, what I'm telling them, they said you should come back before 1st October. I'm advising them, you can't stay there. It's only stick, you say we kill if you stand. You make a move. They should make a move. It's high time they know where they come from. Yeah, really, really. We have our government should now intervene. Know how to handle these borders when they come in this place. When they come in, our borders, we have governors, senators, what are they waiting for? Let us invest here. Most of them, they don't invest here. What they need is to not have to go to north and invest, especially that Abuja side. All of the other investments, the governor now would like to have investment in Abuja. We don't have anything on my head here. Just imagine, you see about Golden Guinea here. No, I'm talking about this. See the market. This is market, national or automated market. See how loose how poor it is. What are you waiting for? Still share footing to me.
As for this very proud Igbo race that I happen to come from, by the grace of God, I will do everything humanly possible to serve it with every ounce of dedication in my body, that one day we and our people can sit around and say that this was a fight well fought, and that now that we are free, we can begin to work towards attaining all those potentials that the Most High God gave to us.